Hello, friends, and welcome to See Joy Yoga. It is meditation time, so get yourself into a comfortable meditation position. Don't hurt yourself trying to do some fancy Padmasana lotus something. Find a place where you can find a long spine. Maybe that's lying down, maybe that's seated down low or on something, maybe that's kneeling like I'm doing. Whatever feels right, do that one. And then before you close your eyes, I'm going to talk about the middle of the head. If you were to take a line and draw it from between your eyebrows to the back of the head, and you were to draw another line from the top of one ear over the top of the other ear, where those two lines intersect, that's the middle of your head, okay? So go ahead and close the eyes. And just start to tune in for just a few moments to the physical body. Chances are good that you have some muscles working that do not need to. So check in, and if that is the case, let them soften and relax. I think it's always an interesting study to notice where you're holding your attention. For me, sometimes it's in the same place every time, and then sometimes I end up with this spot I've never noticed before, clenching like a pinky toe or some such thing. So just tune in. And then bring your awareness into your breath. And the first part of this, let's come into a soft belly breath. So remember, that means that the belly is so soft that it moves gently away from the spine on the inhale and back towards the spine on the exhale. And that's not a forceful muscular action. That's just because the belly is so soft that it moves on the breath. And then I want you to bring your awareness up to the base of the nostril. That's the widest part of the nostril, just above the upper lip. Try to feel the air as it enters and exits the nostrils. The sensation of the air entering the nostril and on the inhale and exiting the nostrils on the exhale. You might notice that at the base of the nostrils, you might be able to feel it a little bit more on that area just above the upper lip. You may notice that the inhale is cooler and the exhale a little warmer. And for every stage I bring you to, you can stay right here if this is what's working for you. Right? But otherwise, the next stage of this is that you're going to follow the breath from the base of the nostril up to the third eye, the place between the eyebrows that I touched on my forehead when your eyes were open. And the exhale, you'll follow that breath from that third eye down to the nostrils. So again, on the inhale, you're following your prana, your life force, your breath, from the base of the nostril up to that third eye center between the eyebrows. And when you exhale, you're following it back out from that third eye center back down to the nostrils. You don't need your eyes to help you with this. If they're helping, just let them be in a really soft, gentle position, looking down, and try to just let it be that it's your awareness that follows the breath. If it's helpful to take a moment and touch that area between your eyebrows and put a little light pressure there, and then bring the hand back down just so you have a pressure for that area that I'm talking about, that is always available. and the mind is going to get distracted and go off to other things, not a big deal. When you realize it, just come right back to that breath. And it might just be noticing the breath at the base of the nostrils, or maybe you're following that breath from the nostrils up to the third eye and back down again. Now we're going to try to add on. Maybe that next inhale, you follow your prana, right? So this is also going to be just awareness and imagination from the base of the nostrils up to the third eye center and then straight back to the center of the head, that place I talked about earlier. And with your exhale, it would be from the center of the head to the third eye to the base of the nostrils. Again, you're drawing a line from between your eyebrows to the back of the head and from above one ear to above the other ear, just above it, where those two lines intersect. That's what I'm referring to when I say the middle of your head. It's the same path we started with. We've just added one more stop on the route. So to speak. And anytime the mind gets distracted, no big deal. Just bring it back. Come back to the breath. And maybe following the route of the breath. Not the actual route down into the lungs, right? But the one that we have been talking about from the base of the nostrils to the third eye, back to the middle of the head. And with the exhale, from the middle of the head to the third eye, back down to the base of the nostrils. Now the next time you inhale, you're going to inhale and follow that breath up to the middle of the head, and then try to keep your awareness, your attention there. Remember, you can always go back to any of the stages we have already been at. But otherwise, once we land in the middle of the head, our awareness will leave our awareness there. And I want you to imagine there's an openness there. Kind of like if you've ever yawned, or I'm sure you've yawned, if you've ever paid attention to your yawn, the whole mouth widens, right? All the muscles start to widen and the mouth space expands. So imagine that happening around that middle spot where your awareness is, right? There's just an expansion, an opening. And so this is your space. Nobody else gets to come in here. Nobody else's critiques or criticisms or opinions. This space is just for you. Bring your hands together in front of your heart. Take a big old inhale. Keep butt, chest lifted. Exhale, bow your head in towards your heart. Always coming from and making our choices from love and abundance instead of fear and scarcity. And if there's something that you're grateful for, take a moment and find gratitude here. And if there's not something you're grateful for, try to find something to be grateful for. That would have been a better way to say it from the mat. So try to find one thing to be grateful for, friends. And namaste.